Hey everybody, what's going on? This is Pastor Ben Lim. I'm so excited because we have one of my favorite people. In fact, I think he's one of God's favorite people too. This man of God, I mean, Georgian Banov, he really needs no introduction. He's a papa, father of the faith. He carries the joy. And today we're going to talk about something so incredible about open heavens and Jacob's ladder. But man of God, welcome. Mr. Georgian Banov, we welcome you. God bless you. Thanks for just coming on live with me. I so appreciate it.
Thank you. Great to be here. Good to see you and looking forward to that event coming up.
Oh my gosh. We're going to be together, not just virtual, but we're going to be together very soon on March 10th to 14th. Literally, it's coming up in 2 weeks' time, March 10th to 14th. This conference is called Open Heavens North Hollywood. Okay, this is my second church plant, Georgian. My first plant is in Orange County. This is my second church plant in Hollywood, North Hollywood. There's something that God's doing in Hollywood. And of course, we have you coming out. We have Jamie Galloway and Jesse Shamp and even myself. And I mean, you can't miss it. But talk to us, Mr. Gio. I mean, what are you expecting for this conference? I mean, you just told me that since the pandemic started, this is only your second, third time traveling.
Yeah, the third one. At another conference in LA and somewhere else. Anyways, but I'm excited because Hollywood is the place where I first encountered the Jesus people.
Wow.
On a line waiting for like a movie called The Exorcist. And I didn't pay attention to these guys. Like, they're talking about Jesus. Of course, there's no Jesus. Like, I'm an atheist. I'm raised by the communists. But then when I went to the movie, I freaked out because it was very demonic. And I'm like, I've never experienced any, you know, the communists don't like any kind of a thing like that. So in the way out, I was like scared of, like, I know there's no hell or anything. But, you know, the whole thing was so emotionally. This is where these guys, they were talking about joy and love and God and things like that. And wow. and then eventually I went a little bit up north, and then the second round of Jesus people, same kind of loving Jesus and start loving on me and eventually. So coming to Hollywood will be a celebration for me to my new beginning with Christ started on the streets, Hollywood and Vine, right there in the heart of Hollywood. And so looking forward to that. It's going to be breakthrough. Is going to be connection. You talk about Jacob ladder. Well, I've been to heaven twice, actually, that I go inside. You can see inside, you know. And twice, and of course, every time I connect with the Word and the Spirit in prayer, you just this Jacob ladder is your spirit and the DNA of your spiritual DNA. So that's kind of like, It's always ready for you to climb, so to speak, on the DNA. Like it's part of you, but it's nice to be together and get really focused on it and just to have experiences. I think we're gonna go to heaven. We're gonna experience heaven. It's for everyone. It's your eternal home. And you can come in and do a little tour, peek in what's gonna happen, what's gonna happen. It's gonna be awesome. I can't wait.
Come on, so good. You know, Georgian, I love Open Heavens and Jacob's Ladder, etc. You know, my church plants, our church movement is called Open Heavens. Wow. And, you know, and there's something about Hollywood and L.A. I'm born and raised in L.A. I love Los Angeles. I love Southern California. But there's something about these liberal cities that have been plugged up by demons, principalities, high places, powers. But God wants to break through all these demonic strongholds, and he wants to release portals of angels and portals of wealth and portals of revival. And so I believe even with this conference, with you coming here, what you carry, man of God, we've missed you. I'll say we missed you in California because, of course, I know you come so often to, you know, Papa Che, Apostle Cheon's church, H-Rock. But, you know, we need your mantle and your presence in Hollywood and in L.A. So I know you coming here for this conference. I mean, it's going to shift this region. But I want you to talk to us real quick just how important it is for us to have these glory parties, these joy feasts, these conventions together, you know, because, you know, I mean, people are convening in the strip clubs, in the bars. People are always convening with the riots or, you know, with looting or whatnot. But how important do you think it is for us to convene in the power and the glory of God, loving Jesus? And as we do that, angels are released, miracles happen, people are getting saved. How important do you think it is to open up these portals of Jesus Christ in Hollywood and LA and these other major cities?
Yeah, extremely important, because when two put together, let's say you're spiritually, you can put 1,000 to flight, and you're a friend also, but when you come together, 1,000 plus 1,000, it's 2,000, but really it's 10,000.
Yeah.
So that's what's happening in a multiplication. That's what the Lord has created us, so that when we join together, there's much greater force of breakthrough. So I can imagine 100 or 200 of us get together. It's like the 300 was so massive. The Gideon 300 was so massive that defeated 35,000. Huge, superior numbers of enemies' armies get defeated because the energy together, the agreement in Christ, it multiplies. So get ready for us to defeat without even, I mean, look at the Gideon's army did not use their swords. What does that mean today? Mean that when, first of all, we don't need to battle flesh and blood. That's one thing. But second of all, these are spiritual swords. We don't need to use the spiritual swords. God will battle spiritual swords with the angelic. What our job is to, you know, they did the shofar. I'm seeing you got to your right there. You had a shofar in a thing, right? Okay. Uh-huh. Well, I mean, there's this is the weapons, really, of the Gideon army. Just the shofar, you know, trumpeting, the announcing the glory of God, announcing the testimony, in a sense, you could say. And the other one, the praises of our God. The shofar is introduced, you know, the praises of the God of the angels' army. He's the God of angelic, all angelic army at his command. So when we praise him, when we come together for worship and praise and prayer and declarations, we're releasing that God's armies. And then the other one was they had the torches, like they're undercover, but then they open them up. And so in one hand, you got the shofar, the praises. The other hand, to me, that's the lie, the truth. You know, we're telling about Jesus and declaring who he is and our revelation. So with these two hands busy with proclaiming and this, you know, there's another one to no third hand for the sword. The sword is the Lord. The Lord began to slaughter these demons. The slaughter was so intense that they actually begin to slaughter each other.
I want you to say that again. I want you to say that. That's so good.
Yeah. Actually, God's anointing through the release, as we release it, that's kind of the Jacob ladder. We're releasing through prayer, praise, worship, declaration, and the word, the truth, the light, those two, as we're releasing it, then God's army, God's anointing comes on the enemy, and what that does is, it's multiple time in the Bible. It's not just one battle. Yeah. Many times the Lord's anointing, as we praise and worship, Jehoshaphat, same thing. All they did is worshiped and praised and declared the greatness of God, and then God falls on the enemy. So even God doesn't waste his energy killing it, because they start killing each other. Demons go against demons. Don't think the demons are organized. Don't think they're faithful to one another. Oh, Satan, our great leader, we follow you. We're loyal. There is no loyalty. There is no. There's a self-slaughter is what happened in the Gideon's army. They slaughter each other. Because the confusion of God, the anointing of God, makes the enemy absolutely freak out. So we're going to cause a major disturbance. With spiritual disturbance. We're not going to go out and cast demons and lay hands on people. We're going to worship.
Yeah.
We're going to declare the Lord. We're going to declare the revelation, the testimony. Wow. The blood has already been poured. We're just going to release it. And the blood of the Lamb going to cover Hollywood. And the demons are going to freak out. They're going to fry. They're going to slaughter each other. They're going to commit suicide. Those are the demonic authorities that are controlling the city big time. Just we're gonna cause a spiritual slaughter, not physical, none of that. We're talking spiritual. Amen. Yeah. It's gonna be great.
My God, this is so powerful. My gosh. I love what our friend Kat Kerr says. I mean, our enemies are gonna get bushwhacked. Like they're just gonna get bushwhacked. So, you know, I mean, this is so incredible, man of God, because I really feel like in this season. You know, we need to gather together more than ever before. I believe in the virtual events. I believe in the power of media and social media, cyber evangelism. I believe all that. But we, the church, we're essential. And we need to gather in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Ghost together today more than ever before. And when we do that, something supernatural happens. I mean, you can't imagine that there was 120 that was gathered in different places in the upper room. No, they were in one place together. And there's something that happens. And I feel like the enemy is so scared of Christians. The enemy is so scared of believers. You know, I mean, the one world order, elitists, etc. They're so afraid of God because they're trying to be God. So therefore, they're trying to stop the freedom of religion in America and the freedom of speech. But I know and I believe and we declare that there's a new breed rising. There's a new era that's upon us. And in this year, in this decade, in this era, God is releasing a new breed of reformers and wonder workers that will roar the good news of Jesus Christ no matter what. And it's even happening in Los Angeles. You know, I really feel like, man of God, there's something about the inner cities. I'm from L.A. Of course, I know you have a plant in Harrisburg, and you have a plan in New York, but there's something about these inner cities, and God loves cities, but we believers, we shouldn't vacate and run away and have our exoduses. No, we need to stand our ground because these strongholds need to come down. Talk to us, man of God.
Yeah, the strongholds and the territories, I don't know if you read recently, First Samuel chapter 7 discusses a situation similar to now. The enemy has invaded. Talk about trafficking children. I hear all kinds of crazy stuff. Last year, statistic, close to 500,000 children were abducted. Wow. 500,000 U.S. kids.
In America.
God. This is the stats of the, you can Google it and you can see yourself. It's not like some secret number. It's average 300, 405, close to 460,000. So these abductions, child traffic for all kinds of horrible uses. I don't even want to go in there. But I says, Lord, what can we do for this traffic situation? And the Lord led me to 1 Samuel 7. And what's happening, they were invaded by the Philistines. They basically, they traffic, they use you, they abuse you, they rape you and so forth, and financially in every way. So the Israel rushing to the prophet, and the prophet Samuel had a very amazing, when he prayed, God hears his prayers, that he was famous for that. Like he was connected with God. Talk about this prophetic gathering that we're coming together, the prophets of God. We're the prophets of God. And so they say, cry out for God, because God hears you. This is Israel at the time. Today, the body of Christ is like, we're crying for the prophetic, the answers from God, you know, so we're crying. And the prophet offers a lamb before he was like a milk, like a suckling lamb, baby lamb, which is the type of Christ. On the throne, there's a lamb, lambkin. It's like a baby. It's not a big sheep. Jesus is a lamb. So he's offered the lamb. Soon as the smoke comes out, and I think there'll be a lot of smoke of worship.
Hey!
Smoke, like the incense when you throw it on the altar, and just all the fragrance of worship living sacrifice. We worship the Lord. Woo! I feel it. And the Lord, the nostrils of the worship hits the Lord, and he instantly responds. It's like we're going to see immediate response, not like 6 months later. No, on the spot, we're going to read. In fact, I'll give you a story for that if you want to hear a powerful story of worship. But
yes.
Boom, the Lord falls upon the enemy, and the word panic. The enemy panic, like this go crazy. And they start running around, and it's easy to push out, defeat, panicking enemy. And it pushed them out of Israel. So out of Hollywood, out of
the come on.
We're going to push them out. And then there is a boundaries of Israel could not be crossed. From then, they could not come back all the days of the prophet Samuel, all the days. And he anoints David, same anointing, same says David. And even Solomon, although he faltered at the end of his life and became unfaithful to God, but God kept the borders for Samuel's sake. And David's like the generational layering of the faithfulness of the saints before us is how God is answering. So we're going to push him out. And I'll give you one example. We were in Bulgaria. We go there every year. That's my country. And we ministered to gypsies. Gypsies are our favorite people. They're marginalized. There's a lot of prejudice. Just the same as everywhere. There's this racial thing is crazy. But these gypsies are beloved for us. They get anointed. They love Jesus. They worship her. They're amazing. And so we go to this gypsy church that we one of our churches there. And the church occupies like a side room from a former Turkish bath, you know, and they're renting the one side of it. But we went to get to our church. We go through this big dome kind of Turkish bath. And so it's like echoing. So we begin to praise the Lord and worship. And, you know, just kind of like that. And just we got so excited, begin to build for 45 minutes. It didn't stop. We're just shouting. And it's like,
come on, Jesus.
But guess what? While physically we had fun with this echoey kind of a bat kind of a building, the spirit was moving on us because it was supernatural. 45 minutes without nobody saying anything but just shouting. It's crazy.
Yes.
Guess what? Early morning newspaper of the city. It's called Stara Zagora. It's a big city. The largest, second or third largest gypsy neighborhood. But guess what? Front page, last night, meaning the day we were worshiping. Now, it says the next morning. So while we were worshiping and stuff, that night, the largest bust of traffickers, the largest, something like 16 or so lords of, like, their king, their kingpins, their slaves, they get women, they get their babies, they send them to the brothels all the way to Europe, to Vienna, to stuff, and it was busted. It was busted. Traffic rings, the biggest traffic rings were busted, human traffic rings. So I'm telling you, God's going to do some Holy Ghost connect with the Holy Ghost in such a way that there'll be traffic rings uncovered. There'll be exposure. There will be pushing out. Demonic slaughter is going to happen. So Hollywood will feel the relief. You know how that lady, I'm going on and on, but I'm excited. You know, Paul cast that demon out of that fortune teller.
Yes.
And there's no more. And that's how demonstrated the apostolic. It's going to be awesome. I can't wait.
You know, worship is our warfare. And when we gather, there's a corporate anointing that's released. You know, the first tactic of the enemy or of, you know, the enemy camp is to divide and to conquer. And of course, the enemy, you can read that in the book Art of War or anything. But so the enemy, the devil, has tried to divide and conquer the church. But when we gather as one voice, one faith, one Lord, one baptism, as we gather in one, there is a corporate warfare of worship that's released. And not only does it pierce the darkness, souls are being snatched from the pit of hell, prodigals are returning, there's a wealth transference that takes place, and we take ground back, and we begin to occupy and possess it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I want to read this over you because I'm just feeling the power of God right now, the juggernauts of the Spirit. Genesis 22, 17. God says, I will surely bless you and make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky and as the sand of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the cities of their enemies. Or some translations say the gates of their enemies. People of God, this conference, Open Heavens North Hollywood, Jacob's Ladder, you need to be there. March 10th to the 14th. You need to be here, people of God. I know it's going to be a month. March is going to be a month of miracles. March is going to be a month of marching orders, marching forward. So in March, you need to come. Come to LA. Come to North Hollywood. You need to come, people. That's going to be myself, Georgian Banov, Jamie Gallo, Jesse Shamp. We're going to take possession of the cities and gates. And I'm telling you, it's time for revival and awakening. Man of God, we're about to close here, but any last words before you just pray for us? And, you know, as you invite our people to come, just any last words? Man, I'm feeling the power of God. I feel like I need to go boxing with the enemy right now, you know?
Yeah. And I'm coming with my new book, releasing the joy, God's secret weapon for every believer. I'm coming armed and dangerous. I'm going to empower you. This is the first event that I've gone with. The book just came out from Chosen Books, the publishing. So I'm excited to bring some joy weapons.
Come on.
Joy bombs. We're going to empower you with joy weapons of joy for destroying it's not to do something. We already won. We have the victory. But we're going to, through a praise and celebration, we're going to, from that victory, we're going to release the victory upon others. We're not trying to fight the victory. Jesus did it on the cross. So, Father, right now, just receive the weapon, Lord, is Jesus himself. The weapon of all weapons is Christ coming from heaven on earth and going all the way to the Golgotha, to the place of cross, the where he faced the darkness, faced all the demons. Every demon was faced.
Yeah, come on.
And he conquered. He nailed all the sinfulness and the garbage and lies and distortion and suicide spirits. He nailed it to himself.
Yes.
And then buried all the consequence of the fall, so that when he was raised in the grave, and when he was raised, he raised the new me, the new you, a new race. We're part of the new race. As Ben was saying, the enemy hates us. He hates God, of course, and we're just on his way. But we're the new race, and the wicked one touches it now. We cannot be stopped. The enemy does. We cannot be stopped. We never have been stopped since 2,000 years now, and will not be stopped now. We're invading. Christ is invading, and through this event, he's going to invade the dark corners of Hollywood. The light will shine. People will be set free from the demons that are controlling them. We're going to cast out demons through the praises of God. We're just not going to mess with them. We're just going to praise, worship, and God will do the casting. God will do the deliverance for those who are possessed by demons in the name of Jesus. So I can't wait to experience that. Come on, let's experience it together. Amen.
Ooh, hallelujah. My gosh, people of God, I mean, this was a very power-packed broadcast. I really love this because we're warriors in Christ. And, you know, we're not only warriors, but we are the warrior bride. And so, therefore, we are, as we love on the Lord, our love dispels darkness. Our love sets the captives free. Man of God, we can't wait to have you here at our conference, Open Heavens North Hollywood, March 10th to the 14th. Y'all need to fly here, swim here, ride a train here, drive here, run here. Whatever you got to do, get here. It's going to be life-changing. Thanks so much, Mr. Georgian Banov. We can't wait to see you with your new book, The Joy Book. And oh, that's going to be a game changer. I can't wait to just throw it out to the people and just release it, you know. Amen. People, God, this is Ben Lim, Pastor Ben with the Apostle of Joy, Georgian Banov. We love you. We can't wait to see you here in North Hollywood and Los Angeles. And do like, subscribe. Make sure you register. All the information is there right now. God bless you. See you soon.